Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another awesome Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, everybody's talking about AI. Let's see if we can make something kind of AI-like in Tinkercad. Start by hitting create, and let's choose Codeblocks. We're going to change the name to Gradient, and we're going to put AI. We're going to build our gradient with a box. Simply bring it out, stretch it out. I'm going to tell you the numbers I want to choose are 40 and 40, and then we are going to use a variable for this length, which we're going to call depth. Let's quickly create that variable. When you hit create variable, we are going to name it. We want it to be depth, and then I'm going to bring out a set depth, and I'm going to tell you to set that depth to 1. Let's move down to those variables. Let's bring the depth out and drop it in the box. I do want to remind you, we always drop the left edge. If you drop the right edge, it goes in the wrong box. So it's the left edge to put it in there. If you hit play, you'll see we have a cube. If you look closely, it is at the position of 0, 0. We're going to fix that with a move. Simply drop it in, and then remember the height was 40, so we're going to raise it up 20. If you hit play again, notice I have sped it up. Bam! It is at the top of the work plane. And it's a 40 by 40 by 1 in depth cube. Now to make a gradient, we're going to push this back with another variable called nudge. Go to variables, create variable, type the word nudge, press enter. We're going to set that nudge, drop it in. Notice it says depth, so we just switch to nudge. And then it's going to be the same as the depth, because that's how far back it will push. I'm going to raise this up just a little bit, and we're going to make one more variable, hit create variable, and this one is going to be called the gradient, and tell it OK. Once again, we're going to set. This one is going to be that gradient, and we'll talk about those a little bit later. Right now, we'll leave it at 0. Now, to make this gradient, we're going to use the awesome count with command. Notice we can set it down anywhere and put our parts inside. Initially it counts from 1 to 10. Because we are making a cube, we want to change that to 40. And then we need to find our variable nudge to move it backwards to get ready for the next part. And now we're going to use an awesome set color. The one we want is called set HSB, which is hue, saturation, and brightness. Real quickly, if you look up HSB, 0 is red, 90 is a green, 180 is a cyan, purple is 270, and the other numbers are as follows. I'll highlight those later so that you can see them. Right now, though, we want to bring in that variable so that when we type the number up top, right here, it'll start our project with that color. Now comes the magic. We need to bring out the change command. And we want to change the nudge. Make sure you switch that. And we're going to change it by 1 because that's what our depth was. These numbers will always be similar. And then we also want to change our gradient. And right now, notice you do have to switch to gradient. And I'm going to set it as 2 right now. And I'll show you other options in a minute. Number 0, remember, is red. So right now, if we hit play, bingo. You can see it starts with red and moves back to make oranges. Now, just so you understand this, I'm going to set this nudge incorrectly. So see how it's 1, 1, and 2? Notice now we get a gap between every one. So that's showing you how that nudge works. Now, if we had set our depth to 2, and I think we can even leave the nudge at 1. Let's double check. Yeah, then that still does connect. But like I said, I think it's smarter to stay with a cube, so we're going to go back to 1 and 1. Now, friends, I called this AI, and let me show you why. If we click on the gradient and say space it by 5, and if we say we want to start with 90 instead of the other number, when you hit play, boom, it picks the starting color, and it moves through all the other colors just like that. You want to see what it looks like with a gap of 10 in the color range? Bingo! Your hues now have a gap of 10 as you make more and more amazing gradient cubes. I'm going to go back to a blue, so I'm going to type 230, and I'm going to have it go by 2 for the change of the gradient. When I hit play, notice that gives me a pretty nifty blue to purple. If I want to adjust it, like let's say I go to 210 and hit play, it's that easy to modify and find the exact colors I want. When you've got one you think is awesome, what you need to do is export as a shape. I'm going to call this one blue purple gradient. I'm going to copy that by selecting it, do control C, do control V, put that as my tag, but I'm going to change that tag to the entire word purple. I never lock the part size, and then I'm going to hit save shape. Now friends, I can come back and make as many of these as I want, but what I want you to quickly see is that if we return to the Tinkercad workspace, you can see there is the project I just finished. I am going to instead create a brand new 3D design. When we move up here to your creations, bingo! Here is our new cool gradient shape. Now friends, let me show you what makes these awesome. I'm going to go back to creatures and characters, and I'm going to bring in Blanky. Now Blanky is bigger than my cube, so I'm going to shrink Blanky. I could have also grown the cube. I want this to stand up so Blanky's head is purple, so I'm going to do shift rotate. So now it'll stand up on top, and friends, we're going to make what's called an inverse hole. I've got a full tutorial about these, but I'll do it real quick for you here. We're going to click on basic shapes and bring out a cube. So I'm going to simply shift stretch this out, and I'm going to type 50 in the box and press enter. I'm going to take those two, select them, and I'm going to choose a line, and I want to choose the middle, and I want to choose the middle. Note, I always find this easier if I do it from a corner. I do like it at the bottom, and I'm going to simply group it. When it groups, those red lines will go away, and then I'm going to hit T for transparent. So you can see that the hole for Blanky is in there. I'm going to make this whole thing a hole, and friends, are you ready for this? Select the two, do L for a line, middle, and middle, and when you group it, you have an adorable multicolor Blanky. How fun is that? You can do it with all sorts of shapes. You can see here I did the same process with the frog that you can search, and this is also from our gradient chain link project. One thing I will let you know is these are just green spheres that I squished in to give that frog epic eyes. There's so much room for you to have fun and make incredible things using the gradients you make with our Codeblocks gradient project. Now friends, remember when you're done with any project, you can always click on it, change the background color. I'm gonna go with the tan. I'm also gonna shut off the show grid, and I'm gonna close the settings and call that project complete. Do remember the cool part of our project today was being able to make our very own gradients with this tiny bit of code. Friends, I do want to quickly remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad, tons of amazing categories, and then also day one lessons, useful starters, and Tinkercad essentials. Friends, there is also the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. I do also want to highlight the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, we've got more than 700 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL Mod Tech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL Mod Tech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.